Usually, I'd recommend to just read the documentations, but not many people are willing to read such texts. So here is what I do if I don't want to read that documentation. For example, we want to change the background image. What I do is I hover on the background and press the Shift I on the keyboard. This will show the displayable inspector, which displays all the UI elements. So we have here a screen, we have the screen main menu, and we have that here. So if we go to screen main menu, you can find the code here. Now we also have the code for setting the image. So we have your image UGUI main menu. So this means that in our GUI folder, let's open here, we have a main menu.png. It's this one. So we can replace this if we want to change the image. Let's rename our image first to main menu and then replace it. So if we try playing this, Shift R reload, the image will be replaced, but we don't want this overlay. So let's do Shift I again. And we'll see here that we have a window main menu frame. So we have a main menu frame that uses GUI overlay main menu. If we remove this image, it will cause an error. So what we want to do is to comment out or remove the code. So let's find it in the code first. So in my Visual Studio code, I want to open the whole folder so I can search throughout the code, even in other RPY files. Let's do GUI overlay. Let's remove this or just comment it out. We have removed the overlay and we can use this background. Now, if you want to change this text, let's hover over the text and press Shift I again. You'll see here that we have it text inside the button inside the VBox. So if we check here, there's a text start, this one. That is a text button. So that is the text inside the button. If we want to change the text color, we have it here. It says button underscore text. So let's search for that. In GUI.RPY, we can set the text font and size. So for this one, let's just set the text size. This is already defined before. We can either change here, let's say 40. Let's comment this out. Quit. And then let's launch it again. So yeah, the font size is now larger. Or another way of doing this is replace the GUI interface text size. So if we do this, if we change this to 40, Shift R again. It's the wrong code. So let's go there and change this to 40. Shift R. Okay, so we go into start, and if we right click, even the navigation changes. This is because we are changing the GUI interface text size, which is used in multiple UI. So that's one way of changing it. So basically, that's how I just code my UIs. Go to start. Let's say we want to change the alien text. So let's just do Shift I again over it. And we can see here that it is using the screen main menu. But other than that, we have a screen say, which has the alien text, which is what we are going to change. So let's click the say label. And we can see here that we're using a say underscore label. So the text here just means that name box will have the same property as say label. So let's check the say label, and we can see here that we have a text property name. So we'll have a name here. So it means that the property will be used here. To change the font, you can change it here, or if you want to change the text size, Let's reload this, and yeah, it changed. I hope this helped you, and please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in our next learnings.